he's saying you're callable, then he's the kind of guy who makes the world ban. And that's bad.
Yeah, right. Bad. Thanks for taking a stand. We're here talking about racism, and what we're finding is we're all against it. All lines are open. Lots of lines. Oh, don't worry, we'll call security.
No, that's the guy. That's Dr. Becker.
Really? He looks pissed. Let's have him in. That should brighten things up.
Tetzloff, you are a lying, bottom-feeding, low-life publicity whore.
No, Dr. Becker, please, come in. Sit down.
What? I don't want to talk on the radio.
This will be fine. Seriously, sit down. Oh, this is great. We have John Becker here, the racist doctor Mr. Tetzloff wrote about. Go ahead, you're on the air. Talk.
What?
Talk to the mic.
This guy took a private conversation and turned it into something that it wasn't.
Well, then maybe you can tell me what it was. You said to an Asian man, you people can't drive.
Yes, you people as in you lousy drivers. You know, I didn't care where he came from. All I cared about was where he was going, which was into the side of my car. You know, I never said that he was a bad driver because he was Asian.
So you do believe that Asian Americans are bad drivers?
I never said that they are bad
drivers.
Oh, come on, this is stupid.
No, but isn't they just a racist code word? Another way of saying those people?
They is not a code word. They is a pronoun. We can't use pronouns anymore.
And by we, you mean white Americans just like you?
Oh, come on, white Americans, you believe this?
I love this. It's like a real show. Carl, you're on the air.
Yeah, hi, Phil. Long time listener, first time caller. Guys like this stuff to make me sick. Have a t-shirt.
Good point. No shirt.
This woman just proves everything I've been saying for years. Only people dumber than talk radio listeners are talk radio callers.
Shut up, John. For once in your life, just keep your mouth shut.
There's an entire audience made up of the infirm, the unemployed, and the insane.
Oh, with one sweeping generality, you smear this man's entire audience.
It's okay. He's right.
Mr. Tetzloff, in your column, you also say that Dr. Becker insulted a black man.
That's correct.
Blind man?
Hey, wait a minute. It's the same guy. You can't count him twice.
Remind me, Rich. Why do I like him?
Come on, Becker. Just say the name of the diet. Just say the name.
Yeah, and besides, he's a friend of mine. It's the only reason why I go into that place. Certainly not for the food.
Don't say the name. Please don't say the name.
The whole point of my article is to show that racism is alive in this city, and Dr. Becker here is living proof.
I am not. I have strong opinions. Yeah, I admit that. You know, I have likes, I have dislikes, but none of them are racially motivated. Everything I say is motivated purely by stupidity.
Does he mean to say that?
Good one, John.
Come on. You know what I meant.
Well, I certainly know what you meant when you maligned rap music. You're clearly an expression of African-American culture.
I did not. I said I didn't like loud music. All right. I don't like rap music. Is that okay with you? You know, I don't like polka music either. But I like Polish sausage. You know, I hate Chinese checkers, but I love French fries. I hate Belgian waffles, love German shepherds. Can't stand English muffins. Here's a real puzzler. Hate Danish cheese, love cheese Danish.
Yes, Doctor, that's very clever, but what about that mean-spirited swipe at Puerto Ricans?
Puerto Ricans?
You made a crack about people who barbecue on the street.
Those are Puerto Ricans? You know, I didn't say that.
Yes, well, we all know that's what you meant.
No, that's not what I meant at all. I was talking about some guy who lives down the street from me. I don't know where he comes from, but he cooks his dinner on the sidewalk, and that's just stupid. You know something? You are the one that's making this about Puerto Ricans.
That's not what I did at all.
That's exactly what you did. Same thing with your column. Till you took a private conversation, you imbued it with racial overtones, all under the guise of political correctness. You know, that concept was meant to make us more sensitive to each other, but instead, all you did was use it to perpetuate some ugly stereotypes.
Well, that certainly wasn't my intention.
Yeah, well, that's what you did. You know, let me tell you one more thing I don't like. You. You know, not because of where you come from. I just don't like you. And you know something? You're free not to like me either, as long as you do it for the right reasons. And if you don't like that, you kiss my ass.
Great show!